road again. Just can't wait to get on the road again. The life I love is making music with my friends, and I can't wait to get on the road again. On the road again.
Good morning, everybody. It's a beautiful Sunday morning, January 29th. Also happens to be the last day of our winter break, which is sad because I love having some time off and spending some time with my family, getting to drive a little bit, but I can't wait to see you guys. Oh, let's see who's calling. Rabbi Nahum, how are you?
Hello, Rabbi B. And hello, hello, family. I'd like to share with you an amazing story I read the other day about a man named David Schwartz. David Schwartz was getting ready for the biggest meeting of his life. He was meeting in the city, one of the top CEOs of one of the most influential brands in the world. And he had it set up perfectly. He was going to jump in from the city at 4:30. His meeting was 5:15 or 10 minutes out. Take a short taxi ride over. He'll be there 5 minutes early, have the meeting, go home, try to be later. It's the perfect setup for this very important meeting. As he walks into the shul in the city at 4:30, he sees, unfortunately, that the minyan doesn't look like it's going to start on time. There's only five people there. They're looking for the other five, having a tough time getting it. And he's sitting there for a few minutes, people start trickling in, until finally, 10 minutes, 15 minutes past the start time, we finally get a minyan for mincha. And he's starting to sweat a little bit, but he feels like he still has it timed right, he'll play mincha, he'll run right out, take a taxi, take an Uber, and he'll make it there on time still. Praise mincha, comes time for Alenu, he's standing by the door, he's ready to run out, and as soon as they finish Alenu, he opens the door, getting ready to walk out, when somebody calls out and says, please, can you please stay for our beat? Listen, I feel really bad. I would love to stay for our beat, but I really need to go. I have a very important meeting. I'm going to probably be later. I just can't stay right now. And the man goes, please, today is the Yahrzeit. It's the anniversary of the passing of his father, and he needs to say Kaddish. And you're number 10 in the minyan. I need to say Kaddish. If you leave, there's no minyan, and I won't be able to say Kaddish. Please, I really need to say Kaddish today. Please. Please, I beg you, please stay for our beat. I'm begging you. I don't know what to do. Stay for our beat. Probably going to miss the meeting. Probably ruin his chances of landing whatever deal he wanted. Doesn't know what to do. He goes, you know what? I'm going to do it. He goes, no problem. No problem at all. I'll stay for our beat. Man goes, thank you so much. I can't thank you enough. I really appreciate it. Man goes up there. He prays our beat. Our beat's over. David runs out. Takes the taxi. He's the driver, 100 extra dollars to get there fast. Makes these 10 minutes late. He runs up the stairs, elevator, gets to the office. He goes, I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. I'm late to the meeting start. Yeah, is he here yet? Secretary goes, listen, this is the first time I've ever seen the CEO late. Don't worry about it. He's going to walk in a minute. 2 minutes later, CEO walks in, opens the door. Who is it? The CEO was the very person who was Chazan for our beat. It was the CEO's father's yahrzeit. And he asked him to stay for Kaddish. And he saw, wow, you're the guy who's willing to be late for the meeting. Just for me, I'll give you whatever you want. Next few parashiyot, we learn about the plagues, the makot. And they were all given midah and neged midah. Something the Egyptians did to the Jewish people, Hashem sent back to the Egyptians. But we have to view it, the midah and neged midah, measure for measure, is not just in the wrong way, it's also in the positive way. And we're kind to the people around us. We're considerate. We look out to do good for other people. We'll make sure to have the proper midot, but it'll only come back to us. So I wish you all a great day. No Rabbi, please God save.
Thanks, Rabbi Nahum. Great to hear from you. Can't wait to see you tomorrow. Oh, who's that? Rabbi Norman Cohen, how you doing?
Hello there, Rabbi B. How is everything and how is everybody out there? So first of all, I want to make sure people are listening to this. So anybody in school, any kid in school, who comes over to me and says, oh, Rabbi Cohen, I saw you on the daily Torah gets a Laffy Taffy, okay? So let's get that out of the way. Rabbi B, I think we're going to see everybody on Monday, which is, I guess, tomorrow. And you're still driving on the road, and I'm driving coming back from where I went. I went to Israel, by the way, and I drove all the way there. My car got a little wet, but it was well worth it not to sit on an El Al squished flight. Yeah, if you ever been on the El Al squished flight, it's actually called Flight Squished. It's really what it's called. That's the flight number, is squished. Terrible. Anyway, you know what's amazing? What's amazing is that Hashem, when he gave the plagues, because in this week's parasha, we learn about the last three plagues. Arbe Hoshech Makat Bechorot, locust, darkness, and the death of every firstborn. You know, it was like Hashem kept giving more and more plagues, you know? Blood, but wait, there's more! You know? Sifardeya, but wait, there's more! Now, you can imagine Hashem put a break in between every one of the makot, almost 3 weeks in between every single makah. Every plague had a three-week break. And the reason is because when a person has a break and they sit down and they rethink, they reevaluate, their mind is not on overdrive anymore. You know, they think about changes that they can make, places that they can improve. Hashem not only hit the Egyptians, but he gave them time to reflect and to think and to say, you know, now things are calm, but what could I do to stop this from happening? Oh, let the Jews go. But they never did that because that was Hashem's plan. He really wanted the Egyptians to change. All of us now are coming back from a vacation, and all of us as students have places where we could change, where we could grow, where we could do. We start with almost like a fresh slate, because after the break we come back and everybody's ready to go. And everybody tells themselves, listen, I'm going to be great this semester. I'm going to be great when I come back from the break. Just do it. Just be it. Use this time, the few hours you have left, to just take a minute to think about where you are as a student, about what more you have to do to become even better than you really are, because you're probably great. And think about how you could become awesome and perfect, because coming out of the break, everybody's fresh. It's like a new season. It's like the playoffs in the NFL. Bum, 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 bum. No, really. Anyway, can't wait to see anybody. And anybody that comes over and tells me that they heard this message gets a Laffy Taffy. I will be carrying a pocket full of Laffy Taffys on Monday. Everybody have a great rest of the day.
Well, thanks a lot, Rabbi. Hope you had a great vacation. Can't wait to see you tomorrow. And can't wait to see you guys tomorrow. But for now, one last time, I gotta get on the road.